Thanks for the handoff. My name is Brad Curtis. I'll be taking it from here. I'm with Realty 360 View. We're a virtual reality 360 view property tours company. And this is Market Update, how to win at the internet for real estate. So again, my name is Brad Curtis. I have an extensive background in technology development of companies, from concept to development of that company, to fundraising, venture capital, all the way to exits and sale of those businesses. So what is the internet? This is an actual image of the internet. If you go to Wikipedia, it brings up this image. It's a combination of interconnected pieces of content, to summarize it. And you'll see each one of those dots is a different entity on the internet. Some, they look like stars, right? Some stars are big, some stars are small, some have a whole bunch of interconnectivity, and some are just little tiny fragments. But it's good for you to look at what do you look like on the internet, because that is your business on the internet. It's your reputation, it's your reach, it's all kinds of things that make you important on the internet and allow you to attract more business easier. So I'm gonna simplify this by using the search engine periodic table of search engine optimization and algorithm. This is a rule book to follow on how to make the algorithm happy and make sure that your content rises to the top. It's very simple, right? There's about four different categories here. Includes architecture, the coding, content, social media, you know, your personal rankings on the internet, and then black hat stuff. So very simple, right? Just kidding. If you look here on this red part, this is the black hat stuff. So most times you get one of those canned emails saying, I'm going to get you to the top of Google, first page ranking, right? They're going to be doing some black hat stuff, and that's actually going to destroy your possibilities of ranking or doing anything successful on the internet. So stay away from that stuff. So let's let Bill Gates truly simplify for this. Content is king. So the internet is the interconnection of content, rich content, different types of content. Each of these types of content is going to have a different level of competitiveness. Certain types of content, everyone can do, like a blog. Other types of content, like a video, may be a little easier to get up in the rankings because not so many people are doing edited video. So we'll go through that a little bit. So the evolution of the search engine optimization algorithm has changed throughout the years. It's gotten more sophisticated, it's gotten more depth with the artificial intelligence, and it really knows what content's out there. Years ago, we used to be able to have content farms where, say, there was a brewery that was opening up and wanted to drive a bunch of traffic there. I'd go to the top 100 or 1,000 blog beer websites in the world, and I could pull an RSS feed from all their sites and have it all filter into, say, maybe 100 different websites that are pulling all this content in. The search engines didn't know that that was original content or not because the algorithm wasn't that sophisticated yet. Now, you could put a link to that new brewery's website on there and also to their social media and all that stuff, and it looked like there was millions of pieces of content being streamlined to that brewery. It would make them an instant rock star on the internet overnight. Back then in 2011, though, this angry panda, which is the panda version of the Google search engine, it's just called panda, but I call it the angry panda. It came along and realized what was original content and what wasn't original content. The days of recycling content were over. Within weeks of its release, any type of recycling content was immediately downplayed and pushed down to the bottom of the searches. Only original content was able to make it to the top of the search engine. Also in 2014, it became very necessary and mandatory to have a responsive website, meaning that it was able to display the content on any type of device, whether it's a tablet, a phone, desktop, laptop, any size of screen. So that is key to make sure that your site is responsive, or wherever you're displaying your content is responsive. To summarize, original content is king. It cannot be recycled. If you're doing some marketing strategies that's recycling content, putting it on your social media, don't expect a lot of success from that. It may give you some credibility on social media and things like that, so I'm not downplaying it. It's better than nothing for sure, but don't expect it to be as good as original content. This is what I call the marketing wheel. Your search engine optimization, your presence on the website, or your star, as we've been talking about, is surrounded by these different types of content. Now, it's important to remember that your face-to-face is always your most important type of content. Your ability to sell yourself and your business and your know-how in the industry is crucial. It all hinges on you. It all comes back to you, all this marketing stuff. So take continuing education credits, research, be in the know, and also be nice to people and, you know, be proper with people. That's always going to be the key foundation to everything. But from there, you want to have as many ways to create leads for yourself as possible. You know, there's virtual tours, inside out, there's floor plans, there's video, you know, there's putting content on social media, all those posts, they add up. There's the listing sites like Realtor, Zillow, Trulia.com. You have your agent profiles and all those, so you want to fill those with as much content as possible. You know, if you have your own IDX website, that's key. Virtual staging is great. Podcasts, audio, pictures. All these different types of rich content are out there, but which ones are more competitive than the others? Now, having your own website with your own blog and typing up some stuff, everyone can do that. Everyone can write, sit there and type up something. So that's a very competitive place. The internet is filled with words. So that's a very tough place to compete. Photos. In the real estate industry, actually every house has an image on it, even if it's not for sale. It has a Google map image or a street view image or something like that. It's still extremely competitive. So even if a realtor's out there taking pictures with their phone and things like that, you know, you're gonna see here in a little bit that statistically it's not as successful, but you know, you're in a very saturated market there as far as content. So as you reach into other types of content like video, it becomes much easier to raise to the top of the search engine when you do video. If you do virtual tours, it's even easier to raise to the top of the search engines because that rich content is out there, it's extremely desirable, and not many people are out there doing it. So as we look at the internet again and we look at your star, it's really about how big is your star going to be for you on the internet? Because that star is working for you day and night, year upon year, way out into the future for you. And it really stays there and continues to add up, and it builds and it multiplies exponentially as far as your web presence goes. So you always want to be building your star. It really has a compounding effect as you populate the internet with different types of content, rich media content. That video that you shot 6 years ago is still out there. It still points to you and you as a realtor and your business. You can go out there and build relationships, and I recommend you do, and you'll have a nice steady growth of your career over the years. But if you're continually adding content to the internet, you're going to have an exponential growth, a compounding effect, and you're going to have an explosion at some point. And I've done this in many different industries. It happens every single time. You keep consistent with filling it with content, and you will have an explosive effect that has a hockey puck instead of a straight line. All right, so I see the big picture here. Content, you know, it's going to take me a while to develop all that stuff. Well, there's actually a very easy way to do all that. You just click on a button at realty360view.com, schedule a shoot, and it's all taken care of for you. But you want to know, how is this going to affect my listing right here, right now? How is it going to affect my ability to sell more listings, sell more houses, save myself time, save my seller time, save my buyer's time? All right, I'm glad you asked, because we're about to go through the statistics and show you exactly how that's going to happen for you in the here and now. So let's start with photography. Everyone should be doing some sort of photography, but hopefully you're doing professional photography, because just by doing professional photography, you're setting yourself apart and you're able to sell the house 32% faster on average. 64% of the home buyers give great importance to the floor plans and the decision-making process of buying a house. 64%, that's a lot of people. A 3D virtual reality tour of the house helps sell the house 10 days faster on average. This is saving you time. It's saving you money. You get your commission check 10 days faster. That's huge. Now, one thing I want to say about the virtual tour market is that it's only about 8% market penetration right now. So that means just by adding this into your repertoire, into your arsenal of content creation, you're beating out 92% of the agents out there. That's a very non-competitive area. You're able to really shine there. Virtual tours allow an amazing increase on time on page. On our site, people are spending 3 minutes and 47 seconds on average. That's a huge, incredible number on the internet. Think of how long you really spend on one page on the internet. For us to average 3 minutes and 47 seconds is astronomical. But on average, it increases the time on page on your listing 3 to 6 times. That's time that is not being spent on someone else's house because there's so much rich content, they can actually walk to that house, which gives you an incredible advantage over the competition where they have to drive out to that house, fly out to that house, or go out there and spend maybe a half a day just to see what they can get from your virtual tour. Buyers are 90% more likely to call the agent of a listing that has a 3D tour. They're 60% more likely to email. Who would like to have more buyers call them? This is a great stat for virtual tours. 74% of the agents that utilize virtual 3D tours say that they win more listings because of this. That's a huge number. Video increases your inquiries by 403%. That's 4 times the inquiries on average. Buyers say that video is 90% more helpful in the decision-making process. So this is a huge statistic. Video is 50 more times likely to get you on the first page of Google. This is huge because nothing happens on the second page of Google. Virtual staging also has some amazing statistics. This is another unique way to create content. Now I hear agents all the time say, this house is too small for all that stuff. It just needs a couple pictures and stuff like that. Do not let any house be an opportunity lost for your business, because the content you're creating for this little house is going to be there working for you for years to come. Think of your time. Think of your seller's time. Think about any house being a lifelong lead generation opportunity for you. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this was helpful for you. And here's all the references. I didn't make this stuff up. Enjoy.